Hello, everybody. Good evening. How are you? This is the UnderConfident Human, still alive and kicking out here. I'll try to keep this one a little more brief today, but I got a new vinyl. Well, a couple of vinyls, technically. Something new, anyway. Spotted at the record store, and I was like, yep, that's coming home with me. So, due to the size of this, I thought it would be fun to make it into a quick little ASMR video. Let's see what they included here. So let's get our guest of honor, shall we? We have a Deluxe 3LP. Vinyl. Any of you that have hung around before know me by now. This is definitely high on my list of most essential bands. This was also the last album that Typo Negative had put out before Peter Steele passed away. This thing's heavy duty, very thick. I'm not sure what all they've included in here. Nuclear blast. We're against it. Groucho Marx. There's our Finland flag. So, side one, dead again. Tripping a Blind Man, which is probably one of my favorite little jams on this album. The Prophet of Doom. And then side two, September Sun, Halloween in Heaven. On the second record, side three, These Three Things, another one of my favorites, and She Burned Me Down. Side four, Some Stupid Tomorrow, an ode to locksmiths, Hail and Farewell to Britain. And on what is apparently the third record, Everything Dies, live. My Girlfriend's Girlfriend, live. Black Sabbath intro, Christian Woman, live. And side six, Love You to Death, live. Black Number One, Little Miss Scarrow, live. And Anesthesia, live at the Wacken Open Air 2007. This bonus record here was not part of the original album, but, a welcome little bonus nonetheless. Let's crack this open. To do that today, I'm just going to use my little Dunlop guitar pick here. Discussed this in the past. Some of my records I remove the shrink wrap, some I don't. In this case, due to the size of this and the fact I believe it's a gatefold of sorts anyway, I'm going to remove it. But don't worry, it'll get covered up soon. Sticker and put it on my record crate. a moment. I'll probably use my own, but they did at least take the time to put some kind of a poly lining inside of these instead of just the paper. I appreciate that. Hiding in here. I like the fake Russian writing and sometimes the real little thing. That's cool. You know, seeing how they laid out these skeletons in the caskets for their, you know, credits in here. The Peter Steele one kind of hits different now, doesn't it? Like how the insides of all these are black, it's a nice touch. So, as far as I can tell, that appears to be it. Quality of the work here. Let's take a look at the records. At least one of them. Holy smokes. Look at this thing. Wonder if this glows in the dark or not, because that off-white of the vinyl there is sort of, I don't know. And then there is, just if you can see in the center section there, a hint of some green splatter. Really find the manufacturing process for records like these. I'm very curious. I'd like to see it. Interesting while they're spinning too. this material that they could have fit a normal album onto, you know, two sides of a vinyl, but they split it up like this. I assume it's the speed at which they mastered it, or that they pressed it. You know, might give it a... I'll do that for sound quality purposes. Anyway, most of the time I will put these in my own sleeves, but I don't know. Is this proper poly lined in here? I kind of like it. I think maybe I'll leave it as it is. As long as it's not touching paper. The way that was laying inside there, maybe in the middle, maybe that's how it's supposed to be. I don't care for that, but just leaving it laying there. Oh, that's better, and it closes properly. That's good. And then we'll take the sheet here. Grab one of my lid sleeves. So that was $40 well spent, in my humble opinion, since I love this band so much. But edition of Dead Again by Typo Negative. Have a good night, everybody. See you later.